so this will actually make you fall through. However, after a few seconds, it'll come back up. So it's kind of this like platforming block that allows you to just, you know, continue platforming over and over again, which I hope is really exciting for, you know, content creators making maps.
Yeah, yeah, you can build like your own platforming levels and then they will repair themselves. That's kind of neat.
Yeah, so as you can see here, I mean, this is drastically different to what caves used to look like. And there's definitely still the old style of caves, but we wanted to make sure that there was much more variety in the sort of caves and the shapes and the sizes you could get. And even here, you can see that there's some water underground.
Yes, so we actually added something we call local water levels. So in one cave, you can might find like a cave lake, and another cave might not have that one. And this also means that we get naturally generated waterfalls, which is so pretty. And it also kind of gives like new ways to traverse the underground. You can actually go cave rafting.
Yeah, that's so you'll see in a bit that our player here will actually use a boat to raft. Mm-hmm. And that is just such an exciting opportunity to be able to traverse the caves in a very different way than you used to.
Yeah, we were playtesting and then one of the devs like, look at this, it's so fun. And all of us just started to go with the boat on the waterfall. It was a lot of fun.
So another thing to note here is that you could see that a lot of the ores were actually glowing.
Different atmospheres, but it's still the same biome. So we're really going to have lots of variation underground now.
Ripstone Caves biome. And whenever I think about the idea of a cave update, the image of stalagmites and stalactites comes into my head. But adding these are pretty difficult. You know, it's a very unique shape that Minecraft isn't really accustomed to. But I think the way that the artist put it into Minecraft works quite well. And of course, there's some mechanics surrounding this. So you can see that someone destroyed the block up the top, and so the dripstone fell down. And also, unfortunately for this zombie here, if you fall, we can actually see that it's basically this growth. And this is called the skulk blocks. And one of the blocks is called the skulk sensor. This is the new redstone block. As you can see, when you place or destroy a block, or if you have footsteps, and as you can see here, I walked next to the skulk sensor, and it's actually kind of doing an infinite loop where the piston is causing a vibration, and then it's activating the skulk sensor and going over and over again. But here, I've actually put a wool block in between the piston, which prevents the signal from going to the skulk sensor. This can allow you to even do sort of directional skulk.
Goats. They're both mischievous and adorable at the same time. As you can see, they live on the mountains, and if you aren't careful, they might knock you off. They also have excellent jumping skills. Mountains and mountaintops that will be more challenging with lots of snow and ice.
You're basically going to find these excavation sites all throughout your world. And you can make this new tool called the brush that is going to help you uncover the mysteries of all these dig sites. So you come to one of these ancient structures and you can sort of use the brush to clear away some of the rubble that may have collapsed in those structures. And sometimes you might even find something shiny inside them. But and this is important. If you are not careful enough, like in real life, you can destroy that artifact. And when that artifact is gone, that artifact and all the secrets it held are gone forever. But if you're careful enough, if you take your time and you're deliberate, you can get some of those hidden artifacts. And for example, here we got a ceramic shard, which is basically how whoever lived here used to tell and pass on their stories.
I love the story sides of the archaeology, because we often talk about that we want to deepen the mystery in Minecraft. And when you find these hidden artifacts, you kind of find like connections and hints. And we will never tell the full story, but these will inspire the players to tell their own stories about their own Minecraft worlds.
Exactly. I think it's going to be really exciting to see what players do with them. For example, here we see an exhibition that someone built for this, where he can compare all the different clues he finds, right, and try to preserve whatever was down here. And he can compare what we found with whatever new thing and sort of try to connect the pieces, right? And here we see those pieces connected in a clay pot, actually, trying to reconstruct them back. And you can create that wherever, however you like. You can create your own stories or try to guess how those pieces used to connect.
Yeah. It's also so fun to be very creative with these new pots because you can put the shards in, like, in any way you want.
Exactly. And when you're pleased with your creation, you can fire them up and you have your own painted clay pot.
It's pretty. So, Nir, is this programmer art still?